time you are doing a biodigester, you can also consider it in this format.
I'm going to show you one of the best ways of securing and protecting the biodigester that you are constructing using the prefabricated slabs. So whenever you construct a biodigester, you remember you have the options what you can use. We usually have the prefabricated slabs, and then we have the block, the corridors preferably. And of course, depending on where you are located, you can also use bricks or whatever works for you. In this video, when you are using the prefabricated slabs, which has already been done at a warehouse and is being brought to site for installation of the biodigester, you will have to obviously do the installation, have it firmly held on this side of it, and then do mortar work, sealing all the joints, ensuring that it is airtight, doing your biodegradation material and putting everything in it, doing the porous, the biodigester bed as well, and then putting the top cover or putting the biodigester biodegradable material in it, and then putting the top cover on it. Then in this particular situation, we also realized that the ground or where the biodigester is being constructed, the filling has not been done yet. So what would be the best thing to do is to put some blocks around the digester just to firm it up with mortar, and then cover it together with the top slab, and then have the mortar all over it. And that's exactly what we did in this particular work.
The biodigester works in such a way that you will have to get the sloping done when you are doing the screeding on the ground. The screeding must be done at a level. We talk about rapid separation or rapidly letting the water out, but we also don't want it too rapid. We don't want a sharp slope. We prefer a level gradient that will slowly seep the water out, because the mindset or the experience also says that toilet water is the only water that is coming, or the water from the water closet is the only water that is coming into the biodigester. We are not adding kitchen waste water. We are not adding the bathroom. We are not adding the sink for the brushing of teeth or washing of face or washing of hand. So we can manage the water based on the number of toilet seats or the capacity of the users of the facility. So those are some of the few questions that we ask whenever we are going to construct a biodigester. We want to know the number of rooms, the number of toilet seats. We'd like to know the type of building. Is it a semi-detached? Is it a duplex? Is it an apartment? Is it a complex? What type of facility is it? Then we kind of base or construct the digesters for that particular users, average users that we envisage will be using the facility.
When it comes to digesters, mainly in certain areas or certain conditions or in certain situations, the soil type that we are going to meet will determine the type of materials that you should use. If you go to a place and or it's waterlogged, it's clay, and the water does actually take a long time before you can seep into the ground or the earth surface, then your best bet is to use the quarry dust blocks. The experience is coming from the father. If you go to a salty place, if you use precast slabs, then a time will come it will just crack it and it will break it, or it will just affect the shape and size of the digester. So then it's best to use blocks in such situation. Blocks are also important when you are doing your work in a waterlogged area where there's going to be a lot of water in the ground. Probably there's going to be a lot of water also in the soak hole, which is going to take a lot of time for it before it goes away. So then that's where the idea of using blocks actually comes in handy. But mainly from my experience, those who do the block works or those who use the block works are the new installers who are also not that good at the business and are learning, and then certain situations are supposed to use block. So in my situation, if I travel outside Accra in the regions, either Kumasi, Takoradi, Cape Coast or whole, wherever I'm working, and then I can't get the precast slabs, then I readily use blocks in those areas. So if I travel outside Accra, then my best bet is to use the blocks. But if I'm in Accra and then I'm not meeting any clay situation and I'm not meeting any of those conditions that will not work well for the slabs, then I will use the blocks. Now, come to think of it, if you are an installer and you're in this business, your business model should be based on the fact that, well, how many digesters can you install in a week? Let's not even talk about day. In a week, or in a month. So if your business mindset is that, or you have jobs and you are supposed to do, and you are using blogs, then you have to cast the top slab. You have to wait 2 or 3 days for it to dry. And then you also have to lay your blocks and wait for it to be firm enough before you can do the inside bed and then laying of the filtration materials and other stuff. And then you have to take the top cover and cover it before you can go. So mostly that one will take you 2 or 3 days before it's done. But if you're using the slabs, that's within a day or less than 4 or 5 hours time, you have finished your digesters and then you are gone. So basically, that's the advantage when it comes to the precast slabs. Have a look at it and see how to cast a precast slab. If it's done well, it must contain wire mesh. It must have the quarter rods or iron rod in it, the 3/8 possibly. It must have all the ingredients and you must use quarry dust. And of course, only cement to have it cast. That one, it becomes firm and then it should be 2 inches or maybe 2.5 inches. And you are not going to have any problems when you do that. The only problem is if it's not installed well and there are some holes around it and then water is seeping through. But an idea of why digesters is that you should not allow water to be retained in the digester. If you are using precast slabs, it shouldn't be a problem. Unless, like I said earlier, the place is salty and then with time, it might just affect the size and shape of the bio digester or the slabs. Apart from that, slabs work best. They work well in all situations and it's not going to be a problem. So in my estimation, precast slabs works best, one, when you are an installer, and two, if you require a small space to install a biodigester.
So the next time you are constructing a biodigester, you can also consider it in this form. Have the prefabricated slabs fixed and then firm it up with blocks just around it. And when you are doing the plastering or the rendering, you can go ahead and cover all the parts. The idea behind some of this construction is that because you are constructing it in a waterlogged area, you do not want water to come into the digester. So you are going to have to use the slabs just to make sure that the inside is tight, is airtight before using the blocks just to firm it and make sure it works to perfection.
Just like innovations in every industry, or with every product, what we've also been trying to do over the years is to bring a lot of innovation into our biodigester construction. We started with changing the wire mesh into a porous slab or a porous pervious concrete. We've also changed the bedding material, preferably having a coconut husk as your best bed instead of using the manure and then the sawdust or the hay that we used to use back in the days. And then, obviously, because of the wire mesh that we had back in the days, or the corrosion of the metal that happens, we were not allowed to use the chemicals, the harsh chemicals to wash the toilet bowl. All those things are gone with some of the new innovations that we've done. So, as part of the innovations, this is also what we also been implementing in some of our works by firming up the digesters and making sure that it can stand for a longer time and then it can stand a longer test when you are doing the groundworks finally for your compound and then your house. So the situation is based on the fact that you are constructing a biodigester at a place and you are using the prefabricated slabs. In doing this, there are situations where when the groundwork is being done, there's grinding and then the filling is being done, the biodigester is affected when it's not done well. I always tell people or constructed that get a mason, get somebody who is technically inclined to even fix your slabs for you. It's not because it's been prefabricated or it's been done already. You can just go and fix it. You still need to make sure that the mortar mixture is right. You are using the right cement, the right aggregate, the coarse aggregate for the mixture. And then you are also sealing all the joints well. And even the covering of it and making sure that you are rendering the biodigester. You are making sure that it's being done by an expert. So that in case there's a future problem, or in case there's an issue when the groundwork is being done, your biodigester is not affected. And one of the solutions for this problem is to have the block done around it.